Greetings everyone. Welcome to my channel Inside Accountancy by Shakun, Accounting Made Easy. Thank you to all my lovely subscribers for showering their love on me and putting such great comments motivating me. I've got some really nice comments which made me really, really very happy. For all those who are coming for the first time to my channel, please like, share and subscribe to my channel and keep motivating me and boosting my morale. So today in this video, we'll be talking about chapter 16, bills of exchange. And in this video, we'll be talking about the meaning of bills of exchange, the accounting treatment of bills of exchange in terms of its uses. And especially we will be talking about the endorsing the bill of exchange. So let's first throw some light on the meaning of bills of exchange. So as I've already explained in my previous video, a bill of exchange is an instrument in writing containing an unconditional order signed by the maker. Who is the maker? The drawer is the maker. So signed by the drawer, the maker, directing a certain person to whom? Directing the drawee to pay a certain sum of money only to or to the order of a certain person or to the bearer of the instrument. So I had explained this definition along with some other topics in detail in my previous, the first video of bills of exchange. You can click on the I button for more details. I had also explained all this with the help of an example where A is selling goods to B. B promises to make the payment after 3 months. A is the person who drafts the document, therefore he is known as a drawer. B is known as a drawee because he is the person on whom the bill is drawn and who has to pay the money. After he gives his acceptance, then we call that document as bill of exchange and it is returned back to A. So this story I had explained in detail in the previous video. Again, you can click on the I button for more details. So we have also discussed about retention of bill and discounting the bill with the bank in the previous videos. Today we'll be talking about endorsement of the bill. Now, endorsing the bill, what is the accounting treatment? Now, before we talk about the accounting treatment, let us first understand that what do we mean by endorsement of the bill. So let's take the same example, which is already clear to you, that A has sold goods to B, B had to make the payment, A made the draft, he drafted the document, B gave the acceptance, it became bills of exchange. So it became bills receivable for A and bills payable for B. Okay, so now A has to wait for a period of 3 months in order to receive the payment from B. Now, let us assume there is another person called C here. Okay, now C is the person who is a creditor for A. That means A has to pay a sum of, let us assume, 1000 rupees to C. Okay, so A has a creditor C to whom he has to pay rupees 1000. Now this bills of exchange also serves as money. It is equivalent to cash also. So what A does is he takes this bill of exchange and he gives it to C. So what is A doing? A is giving the bills receivable, which is to be received from B. That bill A is passing on to C as a payment for 1000 rupees which were due to C. Okay, so C is the creditor of A. A had to pay 1000 to C and A had to receive 1000 from B. So instead of paying cash to C, A is paying the bills receivable to C. Now what happens on the date of maturity? The date of maturity would be after the period of 3 months is over. Now on the date of maturity, see, A is not going to be the payee. Why? Because A had to receive money from B, but he used that bill for payment to C. So now A is not in the picture. So on the date of maturity, B is going to make the payment to C. So C, who is the creditor to whom the bill was given, is also known as the endorsee. Okay, and in this situation, this whole situation of passing on the bill to the creditor, endorsing, is known as endorsement of the bill of exchange. Okay, so this situation is known as endorsement of the bill of exchange, and here the endorsee is also the payee. Who is the payee? The person who receives the payment. Okay, so now the payment after 3 months, which is made by B, is received by whom? It is received by C. So therefore C, the endorsee, is also the payee. So this whole process is known as endorsement. And now we'll be talking about the accounting treatment in case of endorsement of the bill, that what will be the journal entries. So let's throw some light on the endorsement of the bill. In the question, you will be asked to pass journal entries in the books of the drawer as well as in the books of the drawee. For reference, I have taken the names A and B as per the story that I just stated to you. So let us just rebrush the story. A had sold goods to B because we are going to pass the journal entries. So that's why I am talking about the story transaction by transaction. So A sold goods to B. So the first entry in the books of drawer as well as drawee would be regarding the sale or the purchase of goods on credit. So in the books of drawer, the drawer is selling goods to drawee. So in the books of drawer, the entry for sales will come where the drawee's account, B's account will be debited and sales account will be credited. And in the books of drawee, we'll pass the entry for purchases. He is purchasing the goods, so purchase account is debited and the drawer or A's account, being he being the creditor, his account is credited. So this will be the entry for sale of purchase. Then next entry would be, the next thing what happened was that A drafted that document and he sent it to B. Now regarding the drawing of the bill, the drafting of the document, there is no journal entry. Okay, so please mark my words when I say that whenever the person, whenever it is written in the question that the drawer is drawing the bill or he's drafting the bill, so you don't have to pass any entry for that. Then B is supposed to give the acceptance. So when there is acceptance, when B gives his acceptance, then the bill of exchange is formed. That is bills receivable for A and bills payable for B. Now bills receivable being an asset has a debit balance and bills payable being a liability has a credit balance, right? So for acceptance in the books of drawer, our entry will be bills receivable account DR to drawee or B's account. And in the books of the drawee, the entry will be drawer or A's account to bills payable. And an important thing to note here is that when the sales were made, B's account was debited because B was the debtor. But when the bill is made, B's account is credited. That means when the bill is accepted, then bills receivable, a new asset is created. Our debtor is created into a asset, new asset, that is a bill receivable. So our debtor ceases to exist. See, earlier he was debited, now he is credited. So this debtor, he does not exist in our books now. Hamari books mein kya exist karta hai? Bills receivable. Similarly, in the books of drawee also, if you notice, A was credited first and then A was debited, right? So A again, A's account does not exist in our books now. Why? Because the creditor has been converted into bills payable. Now these entries are common whether the bill is retained, whether it is endorsed, whether it is discounted with the bank. All these entries, they are common in case of all questions. Now after the acceptance is received, the next part is, now it is on the drawer what he does with the bill. So if the drawer endorses the bill to a creditor, that means he is treating the bill. In that case, what will be the entry? Now the drawer is giving the bill to the creditor, to his creditor to whom he is endorsing the bill. So let us take for, according to the example we had taken C. Okay, so let us assume that C was the creditor and now A has given the bill to C. So our entry will be the endorsee or C's account will be debited since he is the receiver and the bill is going out, so bills receivable will be credited. This will be the entry. In case of treatment of bill, what will be the entry in case of drawee? Yes, you are very much right, because I've already explained this to all of you that the drawee is not concerned about the fact that whether the drawer retains the bill or endorses it or discounts it. It does not make any difference to drawee, right? So when he treats the bill, no entry is passed in the books of drawee ever. Then comes when the bill is met on maturity. Okay, so on the date of maturity, when the bill is met, now A, will A get any payment here? Because A had to receive 1,000 from B, for example, and he had to pay 1,000 to C. So he has given the bills receivable, right? So now on the date of maturity, A is not going to receive any payment. B is going to make the payment to whom? C, who is the endorsee, or you can also say he is the pay, right? So in the books of A, no entry will be passed because he is not going to receive the payment. He has already settled the bills receivable. But in the books of B, he definitely has to make the payment against the bills payable, which is the liability. When the liability is discharged, it is debited. Therefore, bills payable account is debited here and cash or bank account is credited because payment is made. So these are the entries which we pass in the books of the drawer as well as the drawee. Let us assume that if the entry is to be passed in the books of the indoor C. So how would we do that? Let me open the whiteboard and I'll just explain it there. Okay, so if we were required to pass journal entries in the books of C, who is C? He is the indoor C. So in the books of C, what will be the journal entries? First of all, C is receiving the bills receivable from A, right? So our first entry will be bills receivable account DR. Bills receivable being an asset is debited because C is receiving it and he is going to receive some money against this bill. So bills receivable will be debited to, who is the giver here? A. So to A's, or you can say the drawer. Drawer is giving the bill to the endorsee. So to A's or the drawer's account. This will be the first entry that will be passed. Okay. Now, when the bill, this entry will be passed on the date when the bill is treated. So treatment of the bill. Then the next entry will be passed on the date of maturity. When the date of maturity comes, then what will be the entry? That will be the second entry passed, that is when C is actually receiving the cash. So cash or bank, he may receive the payment through either of the modes. So cash or bank account DR to. Now, although B is making the payment to C, as I explained, I had explained to you that at the time of date of maturity, B is going to make the payment to C. But B does not exist in the books of C. So I cannot write to B here. C is receiving cash on account of the bill receivable, which was received from A. So to bills receivable account, right? This will be the second entry which will be passed. Now let's take an example. A sold goods to B for 20,000 plus CGST, SGST at 9%. So sale is given. So first entry will be for sales. On credit of 3 months, B paid 3600 by check. So some part amount is received through check and accepted a draft for the balance amount. Accepted a draft for the balance amount means bills of exchange. Bill of exchange is created. The draft was endorsed in favor. Now endorsement is done in favor of C, who got the payment on maturity. Give journal entries in the books of A, B and C. Okay. So now let's have a look at our solution. So in case of this question, again, we have to pass journal entries in the books of drawer, that is A, and in the books of drawee, that is B. So what will be the journal entries? First of all, I have just taken random dates here for convenience, although the dates were not given in the question, but just for explaining, I have taken some dates. So let us assume that the sale was made on 1st of September 2019. Okay, so on this date, sales were made by A to B. So in the books of A, our entry will be for sales. So B account DR to sales. Now, since CGST, SGST was given, so at the time of sales, you always know it is output CGST which has a credit balance. So therefore, on this 20,000 CGST, SGST at the rate of 9% each is calculated. So this is also 9% and this is also 9%. At the rate of 9%, we have calculated 1800 and the total amount due from B is 23,600. Similarly, in the books of the drawee also on the same date, we will pass the entry for purchases. Now purchases is debited and at the time of purchases we have input CGST which has a debit balance. Even input SGST has a debit balance to A. The total amount due to A is 23,600. So this entry is for the sale as well as for the purchase. Moving on, then what happens? A drafts the bill, no entry for drafting. Then B accepts the bill. So now next entry would be for the purpose of acceptance. But it was given in the question that he paid 3600 through check. So our second entry, I have made a combined entry here. You can also pass separate entries. So our second entry is, I have debited bank account with 3600 because 3600 was received through check. Therefore, bank is debited with 3600. And for the balance, a bill is accepted. So bills receivable is created for the balance amount. That means out of 23,600, 3,600 is received through check, and the remaining balance 20,000, with that the bills receivable is created. Total amount which is due from B is how much? 23,600, right? So you can pass separate entries also. Bank account DR to B, 3,600. And the second entry, in the next entry can be bills receivable account DR to B, 20,000. Similarly, in the books of drawee also, we will pass this entry. So our entry would be, I have forgotten to change the name. So this entry would be A's account DR to bills payable to bank. He is making a payment through check of 3,600. The bill is created for 20,000. Total amount due is 23,600. Again, you can split this entry into two. A's account DR to bills payable 20,000. A's account DR to bank 3,600. It's your wish. You can pass combined entries also, and you can pass separate also. I would suggest that you pass combined entries because it saves a little bit of time. So now A is endorsing the bill to C. Okay, so next entry will be for endorsement. So on September 1, the bill will be endorsed to C. Our journal entry would be C's account DR to bills receivable. Now, why have we debited C? Because C is the endorsee, he is the receiver. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So that's why C is debited with 20,000. And what is going out? The bill is going out. So credit what goes out? To bills receivable. So this will be the entry for the treatment of the bill. How is the bill treated? The bill is endorsed to C. So this will be the journal entry. Now, I very well told you that how the drawer is treating the bill, the drawee is not concerned. So on the same date, there will not be any entry in the books of the drawee. There will be no entry in the books of drawee. Now, on the date of maturity, since it was a 3 months bill, so therefore the date of maturity will be December 4. So on the date of maturity, what happens is, now let me just brush it up with you. A sold goods to B. A made the bill of exchange, sent it to B. It became bill of exchange when acceptance was given, and it was given back to A. A sent that bill of exchange to C. Now, on the date of maturity, B is going to make the payment to C. So A is not going to receive any money, right? So in the books of A, there will not be any entry for receiving cash on the date of maturity. No entry will be passed in case of the drawer. Now, in case of drawee, the drawee is required to make the payment. So he will make the payment of the bills payable, which is a liability. So bills payable will be debited with the amount to cash or bank, being the cash paid against the bill. Now, if in case in the same question, we were asked to pass journal entries in the books of the endorsee, how will we pass the journal entries? So journal in the books of C. So you will make a proper format. Please don't look, mind my crooked lines here. I'm just making a random format of journal here. So in the books of C, we are passing journal entries where we have date, particulars, ledger folio, and debit and credit. So this is our format. So our first entry will be on September 1 when the bill was endorsed to C. C is receiving the bills receivable. So bills receivable account will be debited. The amount of the bill was 20,000. Two, who is giving the bill to C? The drawer, that is A, was giving the bill to C. So bills receivable account DR, since it's coming in, and who's the giver? A is the giver. So 20,000. That will be the first entry. You can also write the narration, which will be easy for you. Then on the date of maturity, that is December 4. Now please note, these dates were not given in the question. I have just taken them randomly for ease in order to explain it better to you. So on December 4, that is the date of maturity, what happens is, now A is not in picture now, because now the payment to C will be made directly by B. So we are receiving money, so cash or bank. account will be debited since the amount is received 20,000 and the amount is received by B, no doubts, but against the bills receivable. So please note, majority of the students, they make a mistake here. They write to B here. B does not exist in the books of C. C ke liye B koi bhi nahi hai. Okay. C is going to receive the payment against the bills receivable. So therefore, to bills receivable account. 20,000. Again, you can write the narration yourself. So these two entries will be passed in the books of C. So the question is done. We were required to pass journal entries according to the question. So this much is done by us. We have talked in this video about the meaning of bill of exchange, the uses, and especially we have talked about the endorsement of the bill along with the help of an example. I hope the concepts have been clear to you. If you have any questions, please contact me on my email ID or you can leave a comment in the comment section below. I always try to revert as soon as possible to clear your doubts. So please do that. Also like, share and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that already. Share it as much as possible so that it reaches those who are in need. And that's it. Thank you so much. This is Inside Accountancy by Shakun signing off. Thank you.